Dowsa, please. Captain of the Dowsa.
Latin Dowsa, and I'll go in order of that. First is Sinjin, and next is Nguyen, and then Vincent is me, and then Hongyusun, and then Lizongyan.
Okay,
and that's our team.
Okay, thank you. Okay, you know, 主教是 Captain.
Hello, I'm Chen Yi, and he's Yu An, and then Guan Siwei, and Jin Yi.
Okay, thank you. All right, who is Wenshi?
We are team Wu Li Zhuangzi. My name is Dakaway. She's Yipei, and she's Xiuxian.
Okay, according to the rule, we should have like a 5 minutes for the preparation of the reporter, but you can skip this part. So for the report of this first competition, you can skip this part. We're gonna start to present. Do you need the 5 minutes preparation?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Let's start the preparation. Start the time. Okay. We will have 5 minutes preparation for the recording.
Okay, team dioxide, you can start your presentation.
Okay, we're team dioxide. Our topic is color of powders. This is our outline for this presentation. Now let's review the problem. If a colored material is grounded into powders, in some cases the resulting powders may have a different color to that of original material. This experiment is to investigate how the degree of grading affects the apparent color of the powders. Before we talk about our experiments, let's talk about what colors are. Color is that aspect of the appearance of objects and light which depends upon the spectral composition of the gradient energy reaching the retina of the eye and upon its temporal and spectral distribution theorem. And chemical color pigments absorb different wavelengths of visible light. The color won't change from different angles when you observe. There are two theories, crystal field theory and molecular optics. And escape of the crystallized water may be the reason why the color change. And physical color, they include refraction interference. And light scattering and refraction. We think that the light enters and reflects inside the bigger crystal form, and inside numerous times with long distance, the light will be absorbed, so it results in a darker color. So when the particles get smaller, the light's traveling distance and time decrease. So it results in the lighter color. Okay. The two compounds we choose in our experiment is copper sulfate and potassium ferrocyanide. Why we choose them? For copper sulfate, because it is a pure substance and easy to obtain, and we know there are two noticeable stains, one being blue and the other being white. For potassium ferrocyanide, it is also a pure substance too and easy to obtain, and there is no water of crystallization. This is our experimental equipment. Sieve, molecular camera, delta color, spider checker, hot plate stir. ever protein dish, beaker, spatula, and electronic batteries. There are three numbers of mesh we choose in our experiments. To ensure the purity of our crystals, we grow the crystals ourselves. These are our steps. One, first boil the water. Second, add the ingredients in the water. Third, stir the solution until all the ingredients have dissolved. Fourth, leave the resulting solution for a period of time until the crystals grow to a reasonable size in which we can process. That's the picture. Then to answer the size of each anodization are the same. There are our steps. In order to get the close, this RGB codes of the colors, we did the calibration of the colors with image J. These are our equipment. And this is Dr. Cutler spider tracker. These are our results. The first analyzation result of potassium ferrocyanide. We can see that this is RGB code and it ranges from zero to 255. As you can see the colors from start close to zero and in close to 255 when the crystals get smaller. And this is the table. And we can see the RGB code of the red is more close to 255 than the codes of green and blue. So the color we observe is close to red, orange, and yellow. The second anodization of resulting of copper sulfate. Then we can see the similar patterns of the previous result here. And we can see here the arbitrary codes of red and green and blue are similar and close to 255. So the color we observe is close to white. Our conclusion. The main reason of potassium ferrocyanide color change, we think that because dichroism is similar to that of ink. With different ink concentration, the color it shows changes. The small size means the lower concentration. So it causes lighter color. Then we thought the main reason of copper sulfate color change is escape of the crystallized water, but it's wrong. We measure the water of crystallization. That's our experiment. Now let's look at the table. We can see the grounded and non-grounded as the same number. So there is no escape of the crystallized water. So we think the color change is because dye dispersion is same as potassium ferrocyanide. Thanks for listening.
Okay. Right now the presentation of the report is done, so next we will have 2 minutes for the question of the opponent to the reporter. Okay. 电脑助教室, you have 2 minutes. And the answer of the reporter too. So you have to ask question, you answer the question. All right. Okay, stop. 2 minutes.
Can you explain what is chemical color?
Chemical color. Explain it.
There will have only one speaker. But
one,
you
one
have
speaker.
To answer.
Okay. Chemical color. We think that chemical color is why the copper sulfate is blue and the potassium sulfate is red is called the main reason is because of two theory, crystal field theory and molecular optics.
For the next 3 minutes, there will be a preparation for the opponent. Okay. 3 minutes. And after that, we will have 40 minutes between the reporter and the opponent. But the opponent will take the first for the next 4 minutes. Okay, start the preparation of the opponent.
Chemical color All right, time's up.
The opponent takes the floor maximum 4 minutes and discussion between the reporter and the opponent. You're gonna show your terminal. You're gonna show your computer. You need your computer. No, you don't need that. Okay.
Gracias. don't have an argument.
If the opponent have no question, have no nothing to say, so maybe you can, we can start a discussion between the reporters and the opponent. If you have something to say, okay, you can start now. You cannot skip the first 4 minutes. You start the 10 minutes. We're gonna start a discussion between the reporters and the opponent. If you have something to say. All right. Yeah, if you have more to say, you can start now.
Do you know what is optical rotation?
Optical rotation. Okay, the opponent team, they were gonna answer your question, I think.
We don't think this question is related. It isn't related to our question.
So the reporter doesn't think the optical orientation relate to this topic. Is that right?
Yes.
That's your answer. Okay. So the opponent has anything more to ask or to discuss?
Thank you.
Since the opponent has no more question or discussion for this part, so I'm going to stop this part. Okay. So next we will have the opponent to summarize the discussion for the next minute. Okay. So opponent, you can start your summary. Anything about why you asked the optical orientation and why you asked this question? Well, I guess time's up. Okay, we're gonna get to the next stage, okay. The questions of the reviewer to the reporter and the opponent and answers to the question. Okay, we're gonna start. The reviewer, you can start.
The particle is bigger, the crystal is higher.
The shape of the polytope is irregular.
We know it is irregular, so we because the average gradient is the average radiance is just think it is round. It's a rule. If we don't do that, we can measure. So we will need this round.
All right. Okay. The 3 minutes is up. Okay. So the next 2 minutes will be the preparation of the reviewer. 2 minutes. Start. Okay, time's up. Okay. What did you want to say? You should see this. Okay, you're done with your review. Okay, so you cannot get to the next stage. So we will make concluding remarks of the reporter. From reporter, okay. We have to make your concluding remarks. 2 minutes.
The first is that we think the potassium ferrocyanide is no water crystallization, and the copper sulfate has the water crystallization. So we compare the two material. We think it is enough.
Okay, you're done with your conclusion and the time's up. So,
next we're gonna have the question of the jury. Professor, you can start with your questions.
I'm curious about your color measurement. Could you explain your measurement again?
Measurement?
Yes.
Color measurement?
Your color measurement.
Okay. Okay, we use a molecular camera and we take the picture of the data color spider checker, and we use the data color spider checker correct the color, the cover error, because the camera may in order to get a closed state arbitrary code of the colors, we did the calibrate the colors with image J. And how we did the calibration of the colors with image J, just our and we use the data color spider checker. So we use this has the correct color.
This your calibration standard?
Yes.
Okay. So when you mark the size of your crystal, how did you find the? What's your size dependency? Your color code and your size dependence data. Could you explain it again?
Explain it again. We can see the size from the left to the right is get smaller, and we see the code of red, green, and blue is getting close to.
So, one crystal size corresponding to a lot of grains, right? It's not a single sample. You use the mesh to sample your size, right? Mesh. You use your mesh to define your particle size.
Yes.
Right. So what's the total weight of your particle size per sample per size? When you talk about reasonable size of your crystal, what's the reasonable size?
Reasonable size.
Yes.
Okay. Reasonable size is.
You're starting from your reasonable size, then you ground them into powders, right?
Yes.
So you have a total amount of crystal for each grain size, right?
Yes.
Okay. So what's the reasonable size? What's your reasonable size?
Our reasonable size, I think.
Your starting crystallization grain. How large it is. And then did you check the color of the crystal? The original crystal. Yes. Okay, so when you talk about the dependence of your concentration and your size,
yes,
do you have any proof of that?
Proof of that?
The time's up.
The time is up.
All right, since the time is up, so I think the first the competition will be over. And if you're going to make any remark, we're going to keep the grade, all right, first. And then after that, we can have some remarks. Okay. So are we going to show the grades? Yes, okay, so we're gonna show the grades for the reporter. Okay, first, I'll give the reporter 5.
I give the reporter, actually, 9.
Well, okay, that's good.
I'll give the reporter 9.
It's fine.
I'm 7.
Okay, and next, we'll show the grades for the opponent. Okay, mine will be 3.
I'll give you the 3 also.
I choose.
And the last one will give the grades for the reviewer. Okay, the reviewer, I will have 8, grade 8.
Okay, I will give you the reviewer. I'll give you 9.
Okay, and this will be the first competition. And next, we're gonna have a 10-minute break. Well, it's a start.